Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. In this video, we will learn how to design a bistable multivibrator using the 555 timer IC. Now, in the previous videos, we had seen that this bistable multivibrator has a two stable states. And at any given point of time, the output used to be in one of the two stable states. And whenever some external triggering action happens, then output used to switch from one stable state to the another stable state. So depending upon the triggering action, the output used to switch from one stable state to the another stable state. So in this video, let us understand how we can design this bistable multivibrator using the 555 timer IC. So here is the circuit using which we can configure this 555 timer as a bistable multivibrator. Now if you observe the circuit, this circuit does not involve any kind of charging capacitors. So just by controlling the voltage at this trigger and the reset pin, we can control the output of this 555 timer. So in this circuit, the threshold pin is connected to the ground terminal, while via resistor R1 and R2, the trigger and the reset pin is connected to the supply voltages. So now whenever this set and reset pin is pressed, then momentarily this trigger and the threshold pin will get connected to the ground terminal. So by controlling the inputs at this trigger and the reset pin, we can control the output of this 555 timer IC. So now let us understand the working of the circuit by looking at the internal block diagram. Now like we had seen in the previous videos, the voltages at these two nodes of the voltage divider will be 2 by 3 VCC and 1 by 3 VCC respectively. And these two voltages will act as a reference voltage for these two comparators. Now if you see the circuit, the threshold pin is connected to the ground terminal. That means the voltage at this pin number 6 will be always less than the reference voltage. So the output of the first comparator will always remain to the logic low value. And by default, this trigger pin is connected to the supply voltage. So the voltage at the pin number 2 will be more than the reference voltage. And hence the output of the second comparator will be also equal to logic low value. So initially, this S and R both are 0. That means the flip-flop will retain its previous state. And whenever the circuit is just turned on, at that time, the Q will be equal to 0. So we can say that the output of the 555 timer will be also equal to logic low. Now let us see what happens when we press this set pin. So whenever this set pin is pressed, then momentarily, this pin number 2 will get connected to the ground terminal. And hence the voltage at the trigger pin will go below the reference voltage. That means the output of the second comparator will become logic high. And like we had seen, the output of the first comparator will be equal to logic 0. So whenever this trigger pin is pressed, at that time, the S will be equal to 1 and R will be equal to logic 0. That means this flip-flop will get set to the logic 1 value. And hence the output of the 555 timer will also get set to the logic high value. Now, once the switch is released, then once again, the voltage at the pin number 2 will be equal to the supply voltage. So in that condition, once again the output of the second comparator will become logic 0 value. That means now R and S both are equal to 0. And the flip-flop will retain its previous state. So in this case, the Q will be equal to 1. And hence the output of the 555 timer will also remain to the logic high value. Now let's see what happens when we press this reset switch. So whenever the reset switch is pressed, then momentarily this reset pin is connected to the ground terminal. Or we can say that the reset pin will be at logic 0 value. So in this case, this flip-flop will get reset to the logic 0 value. And hence the output of the 555 timer will be also equal to logic 0 value. Now in this condition, as we are not changing the input at this trigger and the threshold pins, so even after releasing this reset pin, the output of the 555 timer will remain to the logic 0 value. And if you see the same sequence on a timing diagram, then it will look like this. So initially, the output of the 555 timer is logic 0 value. And whenever this trigger pin goes low, then the output will switch from logic low value to the logic high value. And once again, the output will become low whenever this reset pin goes low. So in this way, at any given point of time, this bistable multivibrator stores either logic 0 or logic high value. Or we can say that it acts like a flip-flop circuit. But the difference with this bistable multivibrator circuit is that it can operate over the range of 4.5 volt up to the 15 volt. So unlike the conventional flip-flop circuits, this bistable multivibrator will also work at the higher voltages. Apart from that, as this 555 timer can source or sink up to 200 mA of current, so it can be also used to drive the certain devices. Like over here, as you can see, it can also be used to drive the LEDs. So over here, whenever the set pin is pressed, then the LED will get turned on, and whenever the reset pin is pressed, then the LED will get turned off. Now the same circuit can also be implemented using the other ways. But the point is, if you have a 555 timer, then it can be configured as a bistable multivibrator and it can be also used for this kind of applications. So I hope in this video you understood how we can design a bistable multivibrator using the 555 timer IC. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.